Hello and welcome back. My name's Charlie, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to stop your grass from poking up through your rocks. Or maybe you've got some beautiful bricks that you want to put on the ground, but the grass just sort of isn't cooperating. I'm going to show you what it will look like when we're done. So in about three extremely easy steps, this is what we're going to be left with. And you can see as I move this along, it makes the grass disappear along with it. So this way, you get a lot more accuracy over where your grass is and isn't. And now, it's time for me to show you how it's done. So first things first, you will have to be using a runtime virtual texture. If you don't know what a runtime virtual texture is, or you don't know how to implement one, I have a tutorial that is up here. Bam! Show the card. And also a link in the description below, which will run you through it. And in that tutorial, we look at getting the grass to change color based on the landscape that it's on. So this is an expansion upon that, and it's also an expansion upon my landscape communication tutorial, which I'll link here. So if you're up to date with that, if you know how to use a runtime virtual texture, then we're good to go. So let's continue. Literally all we need to do is to go into our material. This is my master props material. And somewhere in here, you're going to put a value into either the specular or the roughness channel. So this doesn't actually have to be connected to anything else. You literally just put a 0 or a 1 into, let's say, the roughness channel for now. The only reason I'm using 0 is that my grass's height is a parameter, but you might want to put yours as 1. So let's just do that for now. So what this means is that whenever an object with this material is being printed to a runtime virtual texture, this is all it's going to give it. It's going to say, okay, in this position, the roughness is 1. And so if we were to then go into our grass master material, what we need to do is go runtime virtual texture sample, and we're going to click on our runtime virtual texture, and up here we're going to select our landscape RVT. It is important to get world position and plug it in here and set this world position to absolute world position excluding material shader offsets. This is really important if you're using wind and stuff, because you can imagine if this is your rock that you're trying to hide grass under and this is your grass, as it blows sideways, it would then get pushed down, and then as it blows the other way, it would pop back up and it would look terrible. So you want to do this before any material offsets. So we're using our roughness channel. We're going to put this into a multiply, and we're going to go ahead and multiply it by a parameter, which we're going to call grass hiding offset, which is going to be a negative value because we're going to want to push it under the ground. So let's set ours to negative 40 for now. Then we're going to make a float 3. This is just a nice way of appending a vector, basically. We put that into the Z because we only want to affect the grass's up and down displacement. And we're going to chuck that into our world position offset. Another quick little thing we'll have to do before we implement this technique is in your runtime virtual texture output for your landscape material, you will need to put a default value into the roughness channel, if that's what channel we're using, because I'm pretty sure its default is 0.5. So that's no good. Let's set it to 0, save that, let it compile for 20 minutes. Now that that's done, we're going to jump back into our scene, and we will find out that nothing's changed. It still looks like shit. But if you're using a static mesh or a blueprint actor, it might even work with skeletal meshes. I'm not sure if they can be drawn to RVTs. But anyway, you're going to go into its details. You're going to type in runtime, and there'll be a little section called virtual texture and a little thing called draw in virtual textures. You're going to click the plus sign, and then you're going to click landscape RVT, and bam, our grass gets hidden. You might have to adjust like the resolution of the RVT to make it more accurate and less accurate and that kind of thing. So lastly, but certainly not leastly, we're going to go into our foliage menu, and you're going to select any foliage things. So, you know, I'm using rocks in my foliage stuff. In here on the side menu, there is an option down the very, very bottom. Draw in virtual texture. And we're going to select anything that we want to be affected and put it in our Runtime Virtual Texture, and now it's being added to it as well, because they use the same master material as my other props. And so now you can see the grass is hidden below them. So a quick bonus tip is, in your landscape material, instead of this zero being the sort of base canvas for this effect, you can use samples of your landscape. So for example, I want the grass to get shorter and shorter as it approaches my sand material and my dirt material. And so you can take a sample of those layers and plug them in as the base of that. What these do is they return zero except for where these are painted. So it's basically doing what we were doing before, except it will start to hide the grass based on, you know, if they're on sand or on dirt. So if I go into my grass material instance and I start to play with the grass hiding offset, you can see that if I put it into the positives, as the grass approaches the sand, it is affected more. So now if I put this at negative 30 again, you can see that as it goes from grass into sand, the grass gets shorter and shorter until it disappears under the thing, and then it also stops spawning, because that's how I've got my grass material set up. So you can effectively put this on any layer that you want. You could put it on your slope mask so that doesn't appear on your auto material and stuff, whatever slope you're using to determine your cliffs versus your grass or whatever. So that is the epic conclusion royale of our tutorial today. I hope that you found it educational and entertaining. As always, liking and subscribing and commenting on this video help get it out to more people, spread this information as far as it can go. And if you're having any trouble at all with any of these tutorials or anything with Unreal Engine in general, join our Discord. We've got 24/7 support. We've got lots of really, really nice people that are available all around the clock that are always willing to help out other people and learn stuff in the process. And so with that, we say goodbye. Goodbye!
Oh, I want to fucking die.